Let there be peace and love among all beings of the universe. Let there be peace, let there be peace, let there be peace. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Namaskar, Namaskar, welcome. Dear Papaji, I really wanted to come up with some questions for you so that I could come up close to you and have you disengage my mind one more time. It is obviously happening anyway because every time I try to contact a question for you, the answer comes up immediately by itself, as if to say, "You silly girl, why ask?" And the simple word "who asks" appears. Who is Pala? What do you mean? The simple word "who" appears.
Well, what I've been finding is when I start doing, when my mind starts going crazy with all its garbage, if, sometimes if I ask the question "who am I," I get into a mental debate, whereas somehow the simplicity of just "who" seems to quiet my mind. I don't know, now it just seems to be coming out.
This "who" which you speak about appears itself. Is it the one who is the "who" of "who am I"?
No, the ego, I think it's the ego that asks the "who" initially, but it seems...
Don't go very close to this because the vagas... So this "who," does it belong to the inquiry, "who am I," or some other "who," which is your ego "who"? Or does it belong to the inquiry, "who am I"?
Well, it's definitely the ego, it feels like it's the fragment of the ego response.
Answer my question.
Yes. Yes.
Don't go away. Answer my question. This, when you make inquiry, "who am I," this "who" appear to you.
This "who,"
"who am I," this "who" appear to you, or some other "who" with whom you are attached. There are many "whos," you see, but all egoistic arrogant. And this who is making inquiry.
There's a lot of arrogance. There's a lot of arrogance inside of me.
Yes.
A multitude.
So, as I don't seem to have any deep pending questions, I do have two favors to ask. There is a brief excerpt in your first book about obeying the moment. I was so moved, but when I read that short piece last year, I would appreciate if you could expound on it little more. The other favor is that you consider a new name for me which would help me stay firmly implanted into the self and truly surrender the ego once and for all. So how can you say you don't have any pending questions? You have millions of questions which are not resolved. Pending question is only one to inquire who you are. This is a pending question and nobody has ever touched it. Among the 5 billion people tonight, not even 5 have touched this question. Who am I? So there is a brief excerpt in your first book about obeying the moment, yes. So rare is a person who obey this moment. What is this moment? This moment means instant of time, no time rather. This instant, half instant, half of the half instant, you look at it, moment from where everything rises and everything falls. All the creation is created from this moment. And if you can obey this moment, you will merge into this moment and become this moment. And this is called freedom, enlightenment, emancipation, love, beauty, whatever. So this moment is not the moment of the watch. This moment is a very different moment, you see. It is within your heart, from where everything is created. Now turn your head towards this moment and not to any person, not to any thing, not to any notion, not to any idea. Turn your face to this moment. This moment is everywhere in everybody's heart, present here itself. Only you are attached to your past notions, ideas, persons, objects. And if you can get rid of these for a single instant, this will reveal itself. Anyway, since you are leaving and you ask for a new name, so we have to give a new name of this family. You are a member of this family and everybody has a name. Everybody has a name of the Satsang family. not the one given by your parents, because your parents have been foolish enough. They gave you birth to put you into hell, brought you to the suffering. So now you belong, you are a child of this satsang. You must start and begin your life with a new name. So I can give you a new name, means I will tell you how to write it, how to pronounce it. The name is I give you is Lakshmi.
Lakshmi.
Yes, here I can tell you. Then I will tell you what is Lakshmi, okay? You can pronounce it very well. You are from states. Okay. So for states, there is no problem. There may be problem for Spanish people. They can't pronounce. This is the name. Now I will tell you the meaning of this. This means prosperity. Prosperity, you see. And also she is a consort of Lord Vishnu. So this fulfills your desires, all the desires. And goddess of wealth also. Wealth, prosperity, everything you can get from this name. Sit down here, sit down there. What are someone's chances of getting a really fantastic teacher like you? Beloved Papaji, I trust you 100%. Love, light from Gunnar, I am leaving. Papaji, who is Gunnar? Gunnar. When I read 100%, I had a doubt. Yeah, I would have talked to him much about 100%, but since I see you every day, and since you have come, and it is you, I accept what you speak about 100%. I have no doubt. And also you don't have doubt because I am looking at you for the few days you are here, and I often speak to myself. I do not know this man, but he has attained he has attained something for which he has come to Lucknow. Because you need not speak. No one need not speak to me. I can find out they were having this reflection of your own Atman is reflected on your face. And therefore I have been seeing and speaking about you to myself. Who is this man? But we didn't have any contact. To speak to each other, but what's the use of speaking? No talk is needed. You have to just listen once, twice, thrice. And if you are very serious, and if you have come for really for freedom and not for anything else, it doesn't take time. Because it is your own Atman. How far you have to go? You can't find it on the shrines of the Himalayas, not in the caves, not in any holy places, not in taking dips in the holy waters, not by giving presents, alms to people. Never you can gain it, you see, because it cannot be gained by anything. It is here now. You have to give up your concepts of other things. It reveals itself. So since you are leaving, any question?
Picture of Ramana.
Yeah.
It's been hanging on my wall for many years.
Yeah.
And now you are here.
Yeah. Enough. Your relationships with these two persons, I think, is quite enough. Because all the rest are going to cheat you, deceive you. Everybody will deceive you. Even your parents, even your priests, they will tell you do this and do that. But it is all cheating. Don't listen to anyone. Keep quiet. Listen to the voice of your own Atman, and you will see. beloved Papaji, once upon a time, in the vast forests of this earth, a family of grizzly bears was living almost untouched by civilization. The sky was their shelter. The father, the mother, grizzly bears were the absolute rulers of that green kingdom. Especially the father was feared and respected by every living being around. It had the heart and laughter of a child. But his hits were deadly. One day, a smallest of the grizzly bear children went all alone into the wild forest for hunting, and in the evening he returned home with a sad face. He went straight to the mother grizzly. "Mom," he asked, "am I a panda bear?" The mother answered, "No, my son." "You are a grizzly bear." There was silence for some time. "Mom," it echoed in the wilderness, "am I a teddy bear?" "No, my dear child, you are a grizzly bear." Silence descended again in the forest. The little grizzly bear went to the father. "Papa," asked the little bear, "am I a koala bear?" A bit astonished, the father replied, "No, my dear son, you are a grizzly bear." Again there was silence. Now the little one took all his courage and asked again, "Papaji, maybe I am a teddy bear?" "No." Papaji rose up in all his impressive might, penetrating the little bear's eyes, and replied with thundering voice, "My son, you are a grizzly bear, pride of our father, the nightmare of every photo safari, the future king of this endless forest, the terror of your enemies, the fearless leader of the grizzly bear's clan." "But Papaji," screamed the little grizzly bear, "I am afraid out there." "Beloved Master, your son sits at your feet asking your help to dispense this fear and whatever keeps me away from myself. In deep love and gratitude, Johannes." Who is Johannes? Come. It's a good story. Where did you pick up?
Came in satsang. Huh? Yesterday in satsang.
Satsang?
Yes.
Here?
Yesterday.
But this satsang has no panda bears, no koala bears, and no teddy bears. They're all tigers. Even the bears will run away from the tigers, you see, even from the cub of the tigers. The satsang, this is not the satsang story. I will give you the satsang story. So once, of course, once upon a time, there lived a laundry man, washerman, you see. So he used to take his laundry on the donkey backs and go to the river to wash the laundry and bring back the linen in the evening on the donkey backs and give to the owners of the laundry. So this is even now in practice. You might see near this river here the people go, the washermen go in the morning, loaded the laundry on the donkey backs and come in the evening, very close, about half a mile from here. Kukrail River here. So once a tigress came to drink water on the river because he used to wash clothes on the river. So when she just arrived to drink water, a poacher shot at her. Poacher, hunter, shot at her. And she died. And he came near and skinned the tigress and cut the head, because these two items are very costly and the heads are mounted, and the people, wealthy people, decorate them on the wall, and the skins also are very costly, tiger skins, and they hang on the walls or keep it on their mattresses. And so he took away the skin and the head, and she was pregnant, and little cub jumped out of the stomach. And this washerman now went to wash his clothes, and he found a cub, little cub, you see, just like a kitten. So he washed it and put it in the basket and covered it with the clothes, took home. And he was feeding milk through the bottle, because there was no mother to give her a tiger's milk, you see. So slowly started growing. Now it walks along with the donkeys, comes to the river side, goes back. Now it is grown, 6 months old, growing very well. And now this washerman is loading this donkey with the linen, started going, this thing carried on for some months. Once another tiger came to drink water. So he saw this donkey, tiger donkey you may call, was grazing grass along with other donkeys. So he was amazed. He says, am I looking correctly? My eyesight is good. This is a tiger and eating grass with the donkeys, while the donkey is the food of the tiger. I can't understand. So just to remove his confusion, he goes towards it, and everybody ran away. The donkeys ran away, along with this tiger donkey also ran away. So this tiger went, caught hold of the neck of this donkey. All the donkeys fled away, but he was caught. He asked him, who are you? says, I am a donkey. Isn't it Parag? I am a donkey. He said, no, you are a tiger. No, sir, don't deceive me, don't cheat me. Because my brothers and sisters will be waiting for me. They have ran away, but they are waiting for me. I have to join them. He says, no, you are very foolish. So he didn't listen to them. Even he says, I am a donkey. He didn't listen. I have my family, my sisters, my brothers. And we live for many months together. Please leave me. Don't torture me. Then he caught hold of the neck, took him to the same river. He says, look, look, your face, my face, are they not the same? So when the teacher, means the tiger, told him, showed him the same face, he can't deny. How can he deny seeing yourself? When you are happy, when you are in peace, when you are in love, how can you deny it's not the fact? So he had to agree, yes, my Lord, I look like you. I look like you. And he says, I am a tiger, so you are. He accepted. Now, open the mouth. Because he could not, he only bleated or brayed like the donkeys. Nobody taught him a roar. Open your mouth and I roar, and just like I roar, you do. And he immediately roared, because he was a tiger, son of a tiger. Only he lost his tigerhood keeping company of the donkeys, you see. So he roared and he became tiger. Uttered a roar, became tiger. Why a donkey becomes tiger? Never it could happen. Grizzly bear cannot become a tidy bear. So roar he learned from his teacher. Instantly becomes a tiger. He was actually a tiger itself, but with the society, with the company of the donkeys, he became donkeys. So actually you are all tigers, you see. Playing with the donkeys, having the company of the donkeys, you forgot how to utter a roar. So now you are here at the bank of the river. Therefore, I also say, you are not a donkey. You are Atman itself. Utter a roar, I am free, and you are free. Because you are Atman. You are not the body, not the mind, not the senses, not anything else. But you forgot with the company of those who are body-minded. Therefore you forgot your own status, you see. You are Atman, you will learn from the teacher that you are Atman, not the flesh, not the bone, not the blood. So this happens in satsang. Gunar is here and some other people, how they utter the roar. Instead of speaking, I am a donkey, why not to speak, I am a tiger? Instead of speaking, I am suffering, I am bound, why not to speak, I am free? I cannot suffer. What does it cost? Thank you. So, Dakshina. Dakshina, what happened to Dakshina again? Hmm. 3:37 a.m. Dear Papa, I just had a dream that woke me up from sleep. In this dream, I was sitting in front of you, very close, while you were giving satsang. Then you began to speak in nonsense to me. I thought you were speaking Tibetan language, so I responded in Tibetan, and you just started laughing and laughing. Papaji, I don't have a clue what is happening. Things are total chaos. I don't know who I am, who you are, or what is going on in this thing we call satsang. Everything is collapsing under my feet. So since you have managed to send me from university back to kindergarten, can you please teach me ABC? Can we start from the beginning? I need your help, Dakshina. I don't think a student in the university, a college student, can be accepted in the kindergarten. And this is not a kindergarten. This place is not a kindergarten. Neither a college nor a university. This is beyond all these teachings. This is beyond all. Even the people who get doctorates from the university or those who have done their school or college have not known what is happening here. This doesn't belong to any university. And surely it's not a kindergarten school. It is something beyond. We speak something else, and the teachers in the university, they teach. What they teach, what they have already learnt from the university. They must have gone to the university, and now they have become professors, and they teach what they have learnt in the past. And here in satsang we don't deal in the past at all, nor the future, nor the present. We don't take any consideration of time and space. So you are here not to study something in the kindergarten. Now you are here to find out who really you are. This you can't learn in any university of the world. No one knows. for the first time you are speaking this language, because there have been thousands of people who came here, 87,000 people who visited this satsang already. No one spoke that I want to go to kindergarten again. No one ever speaks. Kindergarten they have already left behind. Here they have come for something else which they have not heard, not read from any quarter. So all this time you have been understanding and also writing to me also. So this was not real. It was intellectual only. Intellectual questions, intellectual satisfaction. You are not to use intellect, nor the mind, nor the senses to understand who you are. Even now you can try, just like how the donkey becomes a lion, like this you try here, put it into trial. Don't use your mind, nor intellect, nor the senses. Keep quiet and tell me who you are for one instant of time. Just keep quiet. Don't stir a thought. Don't go back to the past notions and ideas and the things and the persons just for 1 second. And if you have really listened what I speak, then tell me what has happened. Not intellectually listening to my word, not listening. Just understand what I mean you to do. Don't touch the mind for 1 second. Because mind is past. Whatever a thought comes in your mind, it belongs to the past. Mind has no capacity to think of the present moment. Always what you think is always of the past, which you have read or practiced or listened from someone else. All is past. So don't touch the mind. Mind is past. And if really you understand what I speak, you have to tell me in this instant of time what has happened. Who are you? This is how Kabir also says, ek ghadi, what I speak is instant of time, ek ghadi, adi ghadi, half of the instant, adi se puniyad, half of the half, that's what he also explains. Ek ghadi, adi se puniyad, sangat ki jo sad ki, kot kate aparad. All your millions and billions of sins that you have committed in the past lives are immediately destroyed by having association of a perfect teacher, you see. You have not got to do anything. The perfect teacher doesn't tell you to do anything. Those are not the teachers. Those may be preachers. Just preaching some ideology for commercial benefits, you see. And most of the gurus, most of the teachers in our country and abroad, I have seen many countries, all over the world I have seen many centers what they are preaching, what they are teaching is not touching this point which is being touched here. They are all commercial to make money. Or everybody in all the centers of the world. You have been to several centers in the world yourself. And not this. You have not sit with a teacher who tells you you have not got to do anything. Simply keeping quiet and seeing in this quietness what has happened. And this is always available to you every time. Walking, talking, sleeping, dreaming, waking, it just takes half an instant. All your life, 100-year span of a human life, you have to just spend one moment to be free. Everything arose from this moment. Creation, even the Creator, arose from this moment, and everything will be destroyed in this moment. So this moment is very important, as the question of somebody here just now, moment. So you have to be very grateful, very obedient to this moment. Shun everything just for one single instant of time. Return back to your own state and you will see what I speak, peace, love, freedom. Because it is within you. Don't hunt, don't search, stop your search. From all directions, keep quiet. Where you have been? You have not come to satsang?
She has been sick, Papa.
Hmm?
She has been sick.
Sick, yes.
Yeah, she started... in a doctor.
Hmm.
Papa, I love you. Hmm. I wanted to sing a song.
I thought you had gone back to Mexico. I didn't see you on satsang. Your daughter has not come.
I think so. She started to be well from the stomach, but yesterday she started to be sick from the cold, the catch cold. She was, the raining was there, I was in the house, and she went outside, she was naked.
Why don't you bring her to her house? She's a doctor. She looks after everybody. Why don't you bring her here?
I don't want to disturb
either,
you.
Either she can go and she can go to your, see your daughter. Yes. Nowadays, there is some cases, immediately some flu cases are there, but she will look after it. Doesn't matter.
Yes, I will talk.
Yes. Either you bring your daughter to her. Yes.
I want to sing a song for you. I was thinking all this week, but I don't know the bottle songs. And this is told me to come to sing, but I want to sing. I sing a song from Mexico, but it's not the bottle song, okay?
She came here alone for 7 days, then she called her daughter, 5-year-old, and she came alone. And now you are with your daughter, and what is the trouble with you? Whole family is here.
You are so beautiful. You are delight. You are so fresh. And I enjoy the moon. Enjoy the day. And you are. And you are.
Nobody weeps while singing and nobody sings while weeping. I will try yours. I will ask somebody to sing and also weep. She will strike. She will listen to some children there. Where is that Israeli girl has gone? Huh? Shukut. Loving Papaji, I know nothing about meditation, but I have felt the preciousness of love. My question is, can love lead to meditation? Subodh. I don't find any difference between love and meditation. Because when you meditate, at that time also, you are loving your own self. And when you love someone, you love the self only, not the person. So this is a mistake which nobody understands. When someone is loving somebody else, it is not a person is loving a person. So when two persons meet whom they love, when they meet, so at that time these both the persons disappear and only love remains. This trick nobody knows. You think that you are in love with someone, and when you go to meet that someone, after having met with, this desire to meet a person is gone. This desire to meet a person is gone when you meet each other. You had a desire to meet, now you are meeting face to face. You have no desire. So when there is no desire, this is called love. Not even the person. Persons are forgotten because they have met each other. The body cannot love the body. Body cannot love the body. And what is body? Bones, marrow, blood, and other kind of liquids. How can you love? What is the body? Earth, water, fire, air, ether. Can you love the earth? Why don't you love? Why don't you kiss the earth? She is the mother supreme. You don't love. Water, you don't love. You just quench your thirst. Air, you don't love, because without air you cannot live more than few seconds. You have to breathe, you don't love. Fire, you don't love, you are afraid. Fire is within you. Fire is within you, 38 degrees centigrade, isn't it? Or 94 Fahrenheit. If this fire is not there, you are thrown into the grave. So neither you love these elements. How can you love any person who is to die, and who is the combination of all these which I just now spoke? Can you love it? No, you don't love. You are loving something which you do not know. When you meet a person, you are not loving the body. So how can you love a thing which is not permanent, eternal? It is born some years ago, will die some years ago. How can you make love with someone which is not eternal? So this drives you to the eternal, but you do not know. If you know that I have to love the eternity, which is immaculate, very fresh, then you will know whom you are loving. You have never loved any person, only you have been loving your own self, but you didn't know. Now find out who is inside you, who is loving someone else. Having known your own love, you will love all beings of the universe, not only men, animals, birds, plants, rocks, everyone you will love. Because the same Atman which is in you is in the animals, is in the birds, is in the rocks. Otherwise, how can they grow? What makes you grow? What makes the animals to grow? What makes the birds to flutter? What makes the air to move? It is that Atman I speak about, which is everywhere. But you have no time to look at it, what is happening. What makes me speak? What makes me speak? What makes you listen? Have you ever thought about it? Same Atman, you see. Thank you. beloved Guruji sometime after Guru Purnima. Who is this man, Lashnath? Mr. Lashnath.
X.
He keeps his name.
He's X.
Huh? What?
X.
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 Oh.
X,
yes, I didn't read the X because I didn't know the meaning. I remember I gave you this name because you had written one very foolish letter and you gave it. And you showed, what was your name? What was your name then?
Premnath.
Eh?
Premnath.
Premnath. So his name was Premnath and speaking foolish things in the letter, so I gave him name Kamnath. So Kamnath, while you translate, becomes Mr. Lust. So now I will see what will you write. Home is where the heart is. My heart is with you. My home is with you. I love you, Papaji. Being able to love you, it is such a beautiful gift, wishing nothing more, just to be in this love. You have given a new life to the wings of my heart. Thank you so much. Papaji, I am writing a new book which begins at Guru Purnima 93. This book is full of empty pages and it also has got a cover, and the cover needs a name. Will you please grant me a new name to inaugurate this new empty book? Love and gratitude, ex Mr. Lashnath. So your name, if you don't want to be, if you become ex-Mr. Lashnath, I'll give you new name, Ramnath. Just the opposite of lust. Kama is lust, Rama is love and happiness and freedom. Do you remember this name?
Ramnath.
Ramnath, yes.
Not Ramanath, Ramnath.
Ramnath, yes. Not Kamnath. Have you compiled a book? When you bring this book, I will just give the title of this book. When you bring this book, empty pages. Okay. I will give very appropriate name. A very appropriate name to that book so that nobody will touch it. Simply turning the pages of emptiness, empty pages, simply waste of time. Who will pay money? One such book I have seen, empty book, no name, and you know very well which I refer to, isn't it? It's a very costly book, contains nothing. very this much thick from beginning to end. Mm-hmm. Nothing is there. And it is 350 rupees for that. I have this book somebody has sent me from Pune. The same book you read. Okay. But this is the book which is selling very fast, like hotcakes. Very fast. And many people here have this.
What I meant, Papaji, was you told me to write a new story from Guru Purnima 93, so the story is fresh. It's not yet written. Mm. That's why it's empty.
Yes, it means your mind is empty, no? Mind needs to be empty, you see. The pages are always empty before writing. So why to spend money unnecessarily, empty your mind of thoughts? Then I will give it a new name of this book. Don't write any thought on your Atman, inside. Don't write any thought. Don't think of anything. You bring this book to me. Beloved Papaji, since our last meeting, I took on the help of a mantra. I am not sure how it came about, but it seems to have been very effective. There is, however, some doubt as to whether or not to continue, or I remember you once saying you didn't normally recommend or prescribed the use of mantra. Can you advise me in this matter in humble gratitude Vedanta? So I prescribe this mantra also just to engage your mind on the mantra and not on anything else. I do recommend mantra for those people who cannot immediately understand what I speak about Atman, that you have not got to do anything. So those people have some sharp intellect just to follow what I speak. Don't think I say, and I say keep quiet, that's all. To some people who need some time to understand or come to this state, they are advised to repeat any mantra that you like of your particular deity whom you love. This is just to see this mind is not running about. So long you are repeating this mantra, your mind is under control. Just as when an elephant is going in the marketplace, and you know the habit of the elephant is to pick up anything that comes in front of him by the trunk. So it has to be controlled. So the mahout, the elephant who takes care of the elephant, is called mahout. He gives in his trunk one long bamboo stick. He is carrying. So when he is carrying this bamboo, he cannot disturb the vendors who was selling bananas and apples on the way, he's already engaged. He cannot do both the things at the same time. One thing holding, other thing picking up the bunch of bananas. Therefore, this is how, like this elephant, not to give two things at the same time, hold on to the mantra, because the mind can hold only one thing at the same time. You can't think two things at the same time. You can't think of New York and Lucknow at the same time. It is one after the other. So as long as possible, you repeat your mantra, and then it will later lead you to quietness. And then at that time, mantra itself will disappear. Having arrived you to the particular deity of the mantra, so this deity will appear in front of you, and mantra is dropped by itself, and this deity will take you to some realized perfect teacher. That is the help of this deity that you will have. It will recommend to you from within. You go to this and this place, and then this teaching will be very effective. Keep quiet. Do not think. Don't have any notion in your mind, and you are free. This is how it will happen. But continue the mantra till it is dropped by itself. Don't give it up. As long as you can repeat, you will repeat the mantra in the waking state, and you will see you are repeating the mantra in the dream state, and you will see that you are repeating the mantra even in the sleep state. It will have so much hold on you. So when you do this thing, then you will see the deity of the mantra has to appear in front of you. So you have to go on repeating the mantra and don't give it up. So just now I promised to this girl from Mexico, weeping and singing at the same time. Now let us see. I will ask some of these girls to sing, or maybe Kabir's song. We are speaking of Kabir this morning. So what he speaks about this teaching of you need just half an instant to be free. So something like that, it amounts to that. Why you are holding back the freedom? Because you are hiding yourself. You are not exposing yourself to the Atman. So this song, there are some girls, they can sing together. And Dr. Yamuna will sing Kabir's song. And Neeraja will come, also some others, I do not know their names, will themselves come. He will sing with you. What name did you give me yesterday? Jabbar? Jabbar?
Javed.
Javed. Mia Javed also will sing. Yes, same. Show me this book. Oh, you are writing on this,
yes? I write.
You are writing. I thought it's a Kabir's book. Chalo, carry on.
We only know one song.
Huh?
We only know one song.
Okay, anyway. ठीक है पर स्वामी जी कहां से आए विशिष्ट गुहा ये जो गुलर चक्की में आए गुलर चक्की में हाँ गुलर चक्की बोलते हैं उसमें चलो आप कब से वहाँ रह रहे हैं आप परशोत्मानंद जी
हैं इन द ईयर 1956 आई वेंट टू स्वामी परशोत्मानंद जी महाराज इन 1959 आई वाज गिवन मंत्र दीक्षा देन आई वाज अ हाउस होल्डर फॉर क्वाइट लेंथ ऑफ टाइम एंड इन द लास्ट अबाउट वन एंड हाफ इयर्स आई हैव बिकम अ मॉन्क
यू आर नॉट स्टेइंग देयर
नो आई एम नॉर्मली वांडरिंग अराउंड बट इन ईयर वंस और ट्वाइस आई कम एंड आई स्टे देयर माय साधु
You are from Kerala?
No, I am from Tamil Nadu.
Tamil Nadu. There was some Swami, he was from Kerala, he was staying there. He was from Kerala.
That's a trust. When Kerala Swami is in charge, he is the Mahant there, Swami Chaitanyananda.
Yes.
He is my Guru Bhai. And two other Guru Bhai's old sannyasins are also there. They are all stationed there.
Because I used to go there, I know Swami Parshottamanandji myself. I know him because he used to visit Punjab. So I used to go and see him there. And there were two people from Kerala who were quarreling among themselves. And one left and was staying in Kailash Ashram. Do you remember it? They were living in Kailash Ashram.
I never used to look at anybody except my Guruji. So as such, I was not aware who was there, what they were doing, and so on.
Because I was there, so he was having one book, Manorama, no? Manorama. So I could read also Malayalam. So he was a Malayali, therefore. So I said, living in Parshottamanand's cave and reading this Malayalam Manorama, you see, stories of the Malayalam. So I had gone with some Americans also, and it was, there were some, trustee, Punjabi from Delhi, who has built these houses nearby. This is a Punjabi trustee, he said, you see. So he invited me to stay there, so we stayed for a couple of days, and there was very good, some tank to take bath also there, yeah, very deep. Now recently you have not visited? Recently did you go to...
I'm just coming from there, because one of my colleagues, Swamiji's, who took initiation from him, he was rushed to Lucknow for a brain cancer operation. He had just undergone. He got a big tumor, malignant tumor.
Who?
One of my Guru Bhaji Swami. One Shankarananda from Kerala. He took initiation. He became a monk in 58 directly from Swami.
Who is this man?
Who he hails from Trivandrum. In those days, he hails from Trivandrum.
Which hospital is there? Is Sanjay Gandhi Hospital?
No, he has now come back home. This gentleman is hosting him in his house.
Achha.
So he is very much there. And I got a letter very late, 10 days it took for his letter to reach. So immediately I rushed by bus to meet him over here.
You are going to Ayodhya from here?
No, I am going back to Uttarkashi because his ashram, there is nobody that he look after. He has to be here for one more month. For post-operative X-ray treatments. So he has requested me to go and just look after his ashram in Uttarkashi. So I shall be leaving Uttarkashi tomorrow.
Uttarkashi is now all right because due to earthquake it was all destroyed. Huh?
No, I was there on the day of earthquake.
It's
perfectly okay. Thank you very much for opportunity to have a question about Swami Parit and last month's mountain call made me so I never thought that I had an opportunity to come to Lucknow for a year or two more and somehow the circumstances brought me and I am so thankful.
Thank you.